Hey y'all, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Nicole. In today's video, we are going to be doing a DIY basket wall on this wall that you see behind me. It's gonna be a lot of fun. If you wanna join me, go ahead and keep watching. So let's get started with a little haul of the baskets that I have. I did get a lot of baskets at Savers, which is awesome because of course they were a really good deal. And then I also got one basket at Michael's that I want to share with you all. Let's start with this first basket right here. Super cute little basket, oval shape, came from Savers. It was $2.49, so super good deal for this really cute basket. Up next, we have all of these. These are like little wicker plate holders is I think what they are. There was a bunch of them, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and I think I still have more in my craft room. So there's a bunch of these that came in one kit, and I think it was like, or in one set, I should say, I think it was like $5 for all of these. So I thought these would be perfect for a basket wall because obviously they'll fill up this big wall that we have behind us and it's gonna look really cute. I also do wanna do a DIY with these where I'm gonna paint some black in them because my kitchen chairs, as you can see right here, are black. So I think it will be perfect if we can add some black into the baskets. So yes, these were a steal at Savers. Up next, we have this beautiful basket. Oh my gosh, I am in love with this basket. It is so beautiful. When I was looking on Pinterest for inspiration, so many people had this exact basket hanging on their wall, so I literally have no idea where this basket came from, but apparently a lot of people have it, and a lot of the pages on Pinterest were saying to shop at Savers, so I guess a lot of people found this basket at their Savers, which is awesome. This one was only $2.49 as well. Super beautiful, can't wait to decorate with this one. And we have this one right here, another really cute oval basket. This one is really cute and I like that it's a different shade than the other baskets. Oh my God, they're gonna look so adorable all together. So yes, this one was $2.99. How is this one more expensive than this beautiful one? I have no idea. This one's even kind of like broken right here. I don't know, but anyways, it's really cute. I don't really mind that it was 50 cents more. Anyways, they're gonna look really adorable together. So yes. Then I have this one. This basket is so beautiful. I fell in love the second that I saw it. Honestly, this was a huge inspiration for me to even get a basket wall going because this basket is just beautiful. I love everything about it, all of the different colors in it. It's just beyond beautiful. And it's gonna bring some of those darker colors into this area, which I'm really excited about. So this one was $3.99. Then we have this one. It is different, definitely different. Square basket right here, and it has some different textures going on. We have this right here, and then of course this part's different, and then this kind of like strap around it. I don't know what you would really call it, but yes, this basket I thought was really beautiful. It'll add a lot more texture and just, you know, uniqueness to the basket wall, so I'm excited about this find too. This one was $4.99. And then we have this basket right here. It's just a really beautiful round basket. It's gonna be perfect. It's not too thick, so it's beautiful. Again, just gonna add a little bit of different uniqueness and texture to the whole wall. This one was $2.99. And last, but surely not least, is the biggest basket of them all. This basket right here, tobacco basket right here. This one came from Michael's. This one was originally $14.99. It's in their spring shop, so it is 40% off right now, and I did have a reward that was $10, so this came out to $8, so I grabbed this and a little really cute little plant, and I mean, I scored for $4. I got this and a really cute plant, so if you're not part of Michael's rewards program, join that because it's awesome. It's so awesome to like open the app every once in a while and to see that you have just like free money sitting there. I was not planning on getting this basket. The second I saw that I had that voucher, it was like, okay, this basket needs to come home with me and it's just gonna add so much to the wall. So that is all of my baskets, y'all. Let's get into the DIY where we add some black into some of those plate holders that we saw, and then we will get to decorating the actual wall. all of those are painted outside. We are gonna do a little DIY with some of the other baskets that we have. And I'm gonna show you my little inspiration picture right here. It is from Pottery Barn. I'm gonna try to do the one that looks like kind of like it has a flower on it. I'm gonna try to do that with some of these baskets. And well, it's way cheaper. I mean, these are $3.99 for these three. Of course, they're probably way bigger than what I'm doing, but still, like, the look for less, once again, Pottery Barn look for less, which is awesome. So let's go ahead and just try it and see what we come up with. I mean, what's the worst that can happen? I have a ton of those baskets, so let's just get into it. So this is the paint that I'm going to be using. It matches the spray paint that we used on the other plates. However, of course, if you have black acrylic craft paint, I would use that. I just didn't have any more left. And when I was at Lowe's to get the spray paint, I just grabbed this while I was there. So here is the finished product of the two plates that we painted in Pottery Barn style. I love how they came out. I think they just look so perfect. All right, y'all, so now we are done with the DIY of those baskets and they came out so beautiful. I am so excited to put them on the wall. So I did want to show you guys something really cool because it kind of inspired me. I don't know for what yet, but it did. So look at this. This is on my drop cloth. That is what came out, you know, under the placemats that we painted, and they look so cool, like super cool. Like I almost want to hang this up somehow. It looks messy, but it looks cool. So I don't know. It's a cool idea. Maybe something else, some other type of wall decor that I can do in the future with, I mean, that those placemats as like a stencil, that'd be really cool. So I don't know what I'm gonna do with that, but I thought it was cool and I thought I'd show you guys because I don't know, maybe if you guys find something like that and you wanna make some wall art, you can just use them as stencils. That would look really pretty. So let's get to the next phase, which is gonna be making stencils. That way we can use stencils for the wall to see where we're gonna be putting all of the baskets. Okay, so now for this part, you're gonna need some paper and some tape and some scissors that I don't have here right now, but I'll go grab them in a second. And all we're gonna do is we're just gonna make little stencils of each basket. So if you need to, of course, you can go ahead and tape two or three pieces of paper together so that you can make the stencil. These stencils we will then take to the wall. That way we can get an idea of where all of the baskets are gonna hang. All right, so since this basket is too big to fit on one sheet of paper, we are gonna tape two sheets of paper together. That way we can get a perfect stencil of this one. All right, so now that we have it traced out, I'm gonna cut it out. That way we have the stencil of the first basket, and then we're gonna make stencils for every single basket. That way, like I said, we don't make unnecessary holes in the wall. We'll just make the one hole for the one basket.
So for the next part,
part, we are down here on the floor because we are gonna be putting all of our baskets, laying them out exactly how we want them to look on the wall. That way we get an idea of it, and then we will take our stencils and transfer it over to the wall. All right, y'all, so now this is how I want my baskets to be laid out. So let's go ahead and get the stencils on the wall. So we're just gonna put the corresponding stencils for the baskets the way that we had them laid on the floor, now on the wall, so that we can make sure that the spacing is even so we can get the baskets on the wall. So this is what I'm gonna be using to hang the baskets. I'm gonna be using these smaller nails that you see right here. Now you can see how easy it is to hang the baskets because we have our stencils on the wall. So you can put the nail in before you put the basket in, or you can put the basket on with the nail and then pull the paper off afterwards. Whichever is easier for you is the best way to go, of course. And of course, doing it this way saves you a billion and one holes in your wall, which is always the goal. So we are done. The stencils worked amazing. Let me give you guys a closer look at everything. Today's video, y'all. I appreciate you for watching. Thank you guys for subscribing, for liking my videos. The channel is growing and I'm so grateful to each and every one of you. And that's gonna be it for today. So I will see you guys in the next video. Bye guys.
It's a good day, it's a good day.
Yeah, I'm
oh my goodness, it's a good day.